Hello learners, I am Priyanka Patel and today I am going to explain about blow, fill and seal technology for sterile preparation. If you want to learn more about packaging of sterile preparation, then you can go through my previous videos. As you can see in this diagram, this is blowing, filling and sealing. So actually it is one step process for container formation, filling and sealing of sterile preparation. Let's see learning outcomes. So after going through this video, learners will be able to understand about principle of BFS technique, advantages of BFS technique and application of BFS technique. So what is meaning of blow, fill, seal technology? BFS was developed in early 1960s. And initially, it was used for filling of many liquid products like food, groceries, and cosmetics. With advancement and development of technology, has made its use in sterile product, ophthalmic solution, and biological product. If we consider, BFS technique can be used for filling of even small volume like 0.1 ml and large volume like 500 ml plus liquid into a container. As it is aseptic processing in parenteral manufacturing, it enables automated formation of plastic container, aseptic filling of container with liquid, and hermetic sealing of container all in few seconds using one machine. And packaging of the formulation drug takes place under aseptic condition without any human intervention. So it is possible to provide sterile formulation without any contamination. So what are process advantages? First advantage is flexibility in packaging design. As container formation is controlled by BFS product manufacturer, type of container can be selected by formulator only, so it provides flexibility in packaging design. Operation cost is low. It provides high degree of sterile assurance. How it provides high degree of sterile assurance? Because operational person are the main source of contamination in a clean room and therefore represents potential contamination. Automated BFS minimize need of persons and opportunity of human intervention and reduces risk of contamination. Additionally, BFS involve small container opening and short product exposure time, which leads to decrease in microbial contamination. Next one is, small space is required for the complete instrument. Another one is, limited component inventory. Next one is, limited number of operators required. As we discussed that no human intervention is required, so it runs with limited number of operators. Next is, reduce container defects. How it reduces container defect? So as we have discussed, container formation is controlled by BFS manufacturer. So container is formed immediately before product is filled and not affected by flaws in vendor process because it doesn't use suppliers made container and closures. So we can avoid defect which are produced during transportation or which are produced by the suppliers of the container. Next one is easier process validation. As process is fully automated and require little operator intervention, process is more predictable than manual process and less variable and less error. What are the steps which are involved in BFS technology? So first is extrusion and perition formation. Second one is blowing. Third one is filling and last one is sealing. So first one is extrusion molding. If we consider in BFS processing, first formation of plastic container by blow or vacuum molding extruded pharmaceutical grade polymer with an aseptic solution filling system. So we have to fill polymer granules which are continuously fed through a machine hopper in adiabatic screw extruder. and where polymer are subjected to high temperature, usually above 160 degrees Celsius, and pressure where the granules are melt. Then that granules are converted into open-ended molten polymer known as the perrition. With the help of the die and pin set, this kind of open-ended, that means both end of the cylinder is open, which is called as the perrition. And this perrition is then supplied to the die cavity, where it is held and supported by the sterile air. So sterile air generally convey the perrition from one position to the another position, and it shift to the cavity where it will take the shape of the container. What are the polymer choices for BFS processing? So if we consider low density polyethylene, high density polyethylene and polypropylene are the choice of polymer for blow fill seal technique. If we see low, medium and high density polyethylene, barrier property improves as the density of polymer increases and clarity of container improves as density decreases. And for polypropylene, it has excellent barrier property and good clarity and high temperature terminal sterilization. Next is blowing. Molding is done by vacuum slot method. So as you can see over here, this die cavity is closed, and after closing the die cavity, vacuum is applied or sterilized compressed air is applied. So because of application of vacuum or sterilized compressed air, that perrison, which was like open cylindrical tube, it assumed the shape of the cavity and container is produced. But at this stage also, top part of the plastic is still not closed. That means this portion is still open for the filling of the product, and it remains in hot and molten state until the subsequent step of filling and sealing is occurred. So next is filling. As you can see here, the nozzle come above the container and product get filled into a container. So filling main drills comprised of a set of filling tips which held with the protective air shower. Why protective air shower is required? To prevent contamination. And in this small area within the filling machine, that is typically fed with sterile filter air. When the molds are beneath the air shower, the filling tips are inserted into neck of the partially formed container, and then container are filled. Next is sealing. So how sealing takes place? So as you can observe in this diagram, this portion is open, still open, because we have not closed the container and container is still not filled. After filling is completed, this portion of the cavity come together, it closes and it seals the container. So this is how in a single step blowing, filling and sealing is done. So sealing is top part of the container which is still open, and it is in hot and molten state. It get pressed between the head molds, and as a consequence, top part of the container get formed sealed at the same time. So it produces hermetically sealed container. The final step is deflashing to remove the flesh or scrap and trimming of the container and delivering the container outside of the machine. Usually all this process takes around 10 to 18 seconds depending upon the type and size of the container. So what kind of containers can be produced by blow fill seal technique? So as you can see, ophthalmic products for large volume peripherals, for water free injection containers are prepared for blow fill seal technique. You can even observe this kind of container for many cosmetics and for food products. What are concerns with BFS technology? First one is particulate control. Relatively high level of non-viable particulates are generated because of extrusion and cutting process of the plastic, and that may contaminate the formulation or may get mixed up with the formulation. But this disadvantage is already addressed by the BFS manufacturer. How it is solved? So there are mainly two approaches. In some of the instruments, particle generating equipments are kept away from the filling zone and they are isolated with walls and barrier. And for some of the instruments, Parisian system is always bathed with the sterile air. So when it is bathed with the sterile air, the inside particulate contamination, it is removed and we can prevent contamination of particulate matter with the product. Next one is temperature effect. BFS containers remain at an elevated temperature of 60 degrees Celsius for several seconds after filling. So it may affect the stability of the drug. So for that, generally plastic with the lower processing temperature can be used to reduce this temperature. And we can also cool the product immediately after filling and sealing of the container. Next one is oxygen and moisture effect. Plastic, which are typically used for BFS container, provides relatively low barrier to oxygen or moisture, and especially as compared to traditional glass container like vials and syringe. For oxygen sensitive products, filled unit can be placed in foil pouches or other secondary packaging. Sometimes inert gases can be used in these secondary packages to reduce the risk of oxygen permeation. These are the references, and with this I conclude my video. Thank you everyone for paying attention to my video. If you have any query, you can contact me on given address.